Hello, friends. I think we're on. I think we're live. We're doing a little bit of a different program tonight, a little bit of different footprint. My good wife's under the weather a little bit, so we're not going to press her into service, even though she's here making sure that the camera angles are straight. Then we're going to give her the night off. That makes one of us getting our night off. All right, had some songs requested and things that we were talking about online earlier today with various people, including my friend Gina Goff, an Elgin, South Carolina resident, now living a citizen, originally from Elgin, now living up in North Carolina. She's been to Ireland with us a couple of times, and we talked about what are the better love songs out there. And so I'll do a few love songs. It is one day before Valentine's Day, and I'll dedicate all the love songs to my bride over there. There she is. 47 years ago, she became my bride. This is one of the songs that we talked about. Lamp is burning low on my tabletop. Snow is softly falling. The air is still in the silence of my room. Hear your voice softly calling. If I could only have you near to breathe a sigh or two, I would be happy to hold the hands I love on this winter night with you. Smoke is rising in the shadows overhead. My glass is almost empty. I read again between the lines on the page, words of love you sent me. If I could know within my heart you were lonely too, I would be happy to hold the hands I love on this winter night with you. Fire's dying now, my lamp is growing dim. Shades of night are lifting. The morning light steals across my window pane, where the webs of snow are drifting. If I could know within my heart you were lonely too, I would be happy to hold the hands I love on this winter night with you. On this winter night with you. On this winter night with you. Song for the winter's night, of course, Gordon Lightfoot. Gordon Lightfoot, song for the winter's night. I will be doing a few love songs tonight. Yes, it is Valentine's tomorrow night. It's also, today is my son Josh's birthday. Happy birthday, son. 44 years old. Holy cow. And also Bobby Sachs, our mandolin player friend in Charleston, South Carolina. It's his birthday. And others on the Facebook, of course, we acknowledge this one and that one. Happy birthday, one and all. I'll sing a song later for my son, Josh. Anywho, let's see. Here's something just to pick up the pace a little. What do you say? I'm already thinking about my garden in the spring. You know, right after Paddy Day, I start thinking about putting the plants in the ground, buying those tomato plants. So this time of year in February, I'm already trying to get the old tractor cranked. It's been sitting there idle all winter. Gotta get the battery charged up and put a little fresh oil in it on top of the old oil. Anyway, here's a song called The Garden Song. Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless the seeds I sow. God will warm it from below till the rain comes tumbling down. Pulling weeds, picking stones, we're all made of dreams and bones. Feel the need to grow my own, cause the time is close at hand. Grain for grain, sun and rain, making my way in nature's chain. Tune my body and my brain to the music of the land. Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless the seeds I sow. God will warm it from below till the rain comes tumbling down. So plant your rows straight and long, temper them with prayer and song. Mother Earth will keep you strong if you give her love and care. That old crow watching hungrily from his perch in the yonder tree. In my garden, I'm as free as that feathered old thief up there. Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless the seeds I sow. God will warm it from below till the rain comes tumbling down. God will warm it from below till the rain comes tumbling down. Inch by inch, row by row. Garden Song, written by David Mallett, done by Tommy Makem of the Clancy Brothers, among many others that recorded that song. It's one of the oft recorded songs back then. Folk music, Irish folk, American folk, the whole thing. All right, friends, I hope all is well. My wife's going to give me the high sign if everything is okay, or at least let me know if it's not okay. She's downstairs, not up in the studio room. But let's raise a glass. Here's to all us Valentines, lovers and those who wish you were. Cheers, cheers. Little unrequited love song. You give your hand to me, then you say hello. I can hardly speak, my heart is beating so. And anyone could tell, you think you know me well, but you don't know me. You don't know the one dreams of you at night, longs to kiss your lips and longs to hold you tight. To you I'm just a friend, it's all I've ever been. No, you don't know me. I never knew the art of making love, though my heart aches with love for you. Afraid and shy, I let my chance go by, a chance you might love me too. You give your hand to me, then you say goodbye. I watch you walk away beneath the lucky guy to never ever know the one who loves you so. No, you don't know me. Never knew the art of making love, though my heart ached with love for you. Afraid and shy, I let my chance go by, a chance you might love me too. You give your hand to me, then you say goodbye. I watch you walk away beside the lucky guy to never ever know the one who loves you so. No, you don't know. There it is. You don't know me. Great old song, done by Eddie Arnold, of course, all those years ago. And, of course, the jazz guy, Michael Bublé, did a cover on that, too. Great song. Willie Nelson recorded that. Of course, Willie recorded everything. Let's do a Willie tune. What do you say? The reports of Willie Nelson's demise have been greatly exaggerated. He's going to outlive all of us. We were having a country night the other night. I was trying my best to think of this other Willie Nelson tune. Willie wrote this one, and I recorded it. Other people recorded it, too. See, it slipped my mind again. It's slipping out of my brain. Yeah, my mind's full of thousands and thousands of songs, and every now and then one won't pop up when I ask it to. Cheers. Well, let's see. Let's change the key. Let's do that Willie tune. I just remembered it. It's in and out of my brain. Let's do it. Well, hello there. My, it's been a long, long time. How am I doing? Oh, I guess I'm doing fine. So long now, and it seemed like it was only yesterday. Gee, ain't it funny how time slips away? How's your new love? Oh, I hope he's doing fine. I heard you told him you'll love him till the end of time. Now that's the same thing that you troubled me, and it seemed like just the other day. Gee, ain't it funny how time slips away? Got to go now. Oh, I guess I'll see you around. Don't know when though. Never know when I'll be back in town. But just remember, remember what I tell you. In time you're gonna pay. And it's surprising how time slips away. Oh, ain't it funny how time slips away. Willie Nelson wrote that song. You know, it sounds like some of those other songs he wrote, like Nightlife. When the evening sun go down, you will find me out hanging round. Oh, the nightlife ain't no good life, but it's my life. Ray Price, of course, had the hit. It also sounds a little bit like Crazy. Crazy, crazy for feeling so lonely. Which, of course, he also wrote that one. Willie Nelson. I tell you what we're going to do, friends. We're going to pick up the pace a little bit. This one is a song written by my friend Harry O'Donohue. I was thinking a good bit about Harry when we were in Savannah for the Savannah Irish Festival on Saturday. Had a lovely time, good group of people. They didn't know how many to expect after 2 years hiatus. And so they ordered the same amount of beer that they ordered in 2020. And they ran out of beer at 4 o'clock. And they ran out of Jameson at 4 o'clock. So anyway, they had a better crowd than they thought. It was wonderful. Who knows, we may do that again in Charleston one of these days. But the one in Savannah really got a good kickoff back after the COVID and all of that. But I was thinking about my friend Harry O'Donohue. And here, last Monday night, I tried to play a Harry O'Donohue song. And I couldn't remember the second verse. I screwed it up royally. So I would now like to do the Harry O'Donohue song correctly. Can I do that? For my friend Harry O'Donohue in Savannah. How's it going? How's the form? Have a pint of stout, every whiskey to give us a warm. How's it going? How's the crack? Been away so long, it's great to be back. Could be winter, spring, or summer. Scene is still the same. Crowding on the bar, far ajar, before getting on the plane. And the hair stands up on the back of your neck as the plane flies through the night. But you know that you'll be home again by dawn's early light. Saying, how's it going? How's the form? Have a pint of stout or a whiskey to keep us warm. How's it going? How's the crack? Been away so long, it's great to be back. You've already been back over 2 weeks. Does the time really fly? And you put away so much of the stuff you could have drank like earned dry. So you make the best of the time that's left. Pack up your bags and then head for the plane through the tears and the rain. And you can't wait to do it again. How's it going? How's the form? Have a pint of stout or a whiskey to keep us warm. How's it going? How's the crack? I've been away so long, it's great to be back. How's it going? How's the form? Let's have a pint of stout or a whiskey to keep us warm. How's it going? How's the crack? I've been away so long, it's great to be back. Been away so long, it's great to be back. How's it going? How's the form? How's the crack? Written by my friend Harry O'Donohue. He's from Drogheda in the east of Ireland, County Louth, and wrote that song about returning home to Ireland. He takes tours over to Ireland. In fact, he told me last week he's taken 4 tours this year over to Ireland. Harry's basically bailed out of the Irish pub circuit so that he doesn't have to play the bar gigs as much at all. He's doing cruise ships on Norwegian and other cruise lines on the main stage, but he's also taking tours to Ireland. And, of course, I've been taking tours to Ireland 20 years myself, and we're going in October if you want to go. There it is. There it is. We're going in October if you want to go with us. We're also doing England, Scotland, and Wales, mostly Wales, in May, if you want to go with us. There are positions, seats still available on both tours in May for Wales, England, Scotland, and October for Ireland. If you want to go, let me know. Let me know if you want to go. Cheers, cheers, friends. How's it going? How's the form? How's the crack? Cheers. Okay, another love song. This one out of Ireland. Tommy Makem, the Clancy Brothers, did this song. One of the songs that Tommy Makem recorded is so well known for, a lot of people, including myself, at first thought he wrote it, but he did not. It's an old song set to an older melody. It's called Red as the Rose. Come over the hills, bonny Irish lass, come over the hills to your darling. You choose the road, love, and I'll take the vow, and I'll be your true love forever. Red is the rose that in yonder garden grows, fair is the lily of the valley. Clear is the water that flows from the boyne. My love is fairer than any. Down by Killarney's green woods that we strayed, and the moon and stars were shining, and the moon shone its rays on her locks of golden hair. And she swore she'd be my love forever. And red is the rose that in yonder garden grows, fair is the lily of the valley. Clear is the water that flows from the boyne, but my love is fairer than any. Tis not for the parting of my sister Kate, tis not for the grief of my mother, tis all for the loss of my bonny Irish lass, that my heart is breaking forever. And red is the rose that in yonder garden grows, fair as the lily
of the valley. Clear is the water that flows from the Boyne. My love is fairer than any. Clear is the water that flows from the Boyne, but my love is fairer than any.
Red as the Rose, Tommy Makem and the Clancy Brothers. Our program tonight is going to be a little bit different because my wife's under the weather and she's not going to be babysitting the program up here and handing me all the requests as much or doing the. We won't do our shout out for everyone who's tuned in tonight just because it's been she's been under the weather and I wanted to give her some downtime. So. Here's another song. It's almost a love song, not the kind of Valentine songs you would typically have. I wrote this one. once again, I guess if it's a love song, it's unrequited love or something along that line. Anywho, wrote this one and it's on the. It's on the Chasing Daddy's Train CD. It's called I'll Be There For You. Or didn't did a. I didn't did a. Could have left you all alone with them bullies at the beach, but I didn't did a. Broke down on that country road with your cell phone out of reach, but I didn't, did I? Yeah, you always say I bore you, but I've always been here for you. Now don't you know that's true? I'll be there for you. Could've left you last week cornered by that cowboy at the bar, but I didn't, did I? Coulda let that big old dude try to shove you in his car, but I didn't, did I? Something you didn't need's undoing, now you need rescuing. Yeah, now you know that's true. I'll be there for you. I'll be there for you, no matter what you do. You made fun of me, call me old true blue. Well, yes, I guess that's true. I'll be there for you. Could have left you hanging by a string when you dumped your latest fling, but I didn't, did I? Didn't leave you stranded with that stranger. You called your old Lone Ranger. I didn't, did I? Yeah. Anytime you're in trouble, I'm right there on the double. Now don't you know that's true? I'll be there for you. I'll be there for you, no matter what you do. You made light of me, call me old true blue. Well, yes, I guess that's true. I'll be there for you. Yes, I guess that's true. I'll be there for you, no matter what you do. I'll be there for you. Oh, I like that one. You know, sometimes you write a song and you say, man, shoot, I like that one. And so that's the case with that one. Should we have a toast, friends? A toast. I was going through some old paperwork, and I came across this toast that I haven't said in a long time. You know, I should remember all these toasts, but I don't. But I didn't, did I? It's a very old Irish blessing. May your day be filled with blessings like the sun lights up the sky. And may you always have the courage to spread your wings and fly. Cheers. To us. I didn't plan my show tonight or put together a set list, so I'm kind of winging through some old things in here. We'll see what we come up with. What do you say? I'm throwing away more songs than I'm singing. Can you tell? Let's do a little little country music. What do you say? A little South Carolina, Charleston, little country music. I know my friends Steve and Joy Edwards down in Treasure Island, Florida, like this one. Little Charleston music. I reposted the story about how this song came about sometime during the week last week on my Facebook page. It was George Gershwin and DeBose Hayward. DeBose Hayward had written a whole storyline about Charleston and the Gullah culture and in the low country of the Carolinas. And it took a long time before he could get George Gershwin to come down and take advantage of it. But they ended up writing what became a play called Porgy and Bess. Summertime, living is easy. Fish are jumping, cotton is high. Your daddy rich, mammy she good looking. Hush little baby, don't you cry. One of these mornings you're gonna rise up singing. Spread your wings, take to the sky. But until that morning, nothing gonna harm you. With mama and daddy standing by. Gonna rise up singing, spread your wings, take to the sky. But until that morning, nothing gonna harm you. 'Cause mama and daddy standing by. Summertime, living is easy, and the fish are jumping in the Folly River. Cotton is high, your daddy rich, mammy she good looking. Hush little baby, don't you cry. Busted baby, don't you cry. Hush little baby, don't you cry.
cry.
Summertime, that's for our friends in Treasure Island, Florida. Steve also has requested that I do this other song for Joy down in Treasure Island, Florida. I got a few other requests here, too. My wife is going to let me know if Danny Johnson is tuned in and if Edith Reed is tuned in and if Sonny Johnson is tuned in. Danny Johnson, Sonny Johnson, Edith Reed. Let's see. And we'll do this one for Joy Edwards. Song done by the Fury Brothers in Ireland. They come from the farms and the factories too. They'll all soon forget who they are. Cares of the day are soon washed away as they pull up a chair at the bar. A girl with green eyes and the Rolling Stone shirt doesn't look like she works on the land. And the man at the end is a very good friend of a man who sells cars secondhand. Down at the Red Rose Cafe in the harbor, and there by the port just outside Amsterdam, everyone shares in the songs and the laughter, and everyone there is so happy to be there. Salesmen relax with a few pints of beer, and they try not to speak about trade. And the poet won't write any verses tonight, but he may sing a sweet serenade. So pull up a chair, forget about life, it's a good thing to do now and then. And if you like it here, then I have an idea. Tomorrow, let's all meet again. Down at the Red Rose Cafe in the harbor, there by the port, just outside Amsterdam. And everyone shares in the songs and the laughter, and everyone there is so happy to be there. The Fury Brothers out of Ireland. The Fury Brothers was a family of travelers, if you know what travelers are in Ireland. They became extremely popular, and of course they all of the traveler culture harkens back to yesteryear over and over and over, and it was their mother who suggested very strongly that they go find this old song that she remembered. And it was done, of course, here in this country, in America, by this person and that person. What you got there, Mom?
Here's some requests. Edith's on.
Okay.
You said Sonny Johnson?
Yeah.
I can't. He's not okay. On. Angela White is on.
Okay. It's okay.
It's just the ones that are on.
How you feeling?
I'm all right.
She's all right. She's a trooper. She's a trooper. She's got the an old cough, and so she doesn't want the cough to be on the live stream and on the YouTube microphone. So understood, you're going downstairs, and that's okay. Thank you, Mom, for your hard work. Thank you, thank you, thank you. She's tested it 4 or 5 times. She's not COVID positive, but she's bronchitis positive. I'll do some of these requests. Let's see. I was going to do another song from the Fury Brothers. Al Jolson and the likes, and the Mills Brothers and the likes of those people did this song. So did many others. but it was done in Ireland and on the Irish, in the Irish songbook, the pub book, by the Fury Brothers. I don't ever sing this song that I don't think about my friends Carroll and Leo Joyce. Speaking of Valentine's Day and a love story, it was a wonderful love story for 50-plus years. And we lost the two of them within 60 days of each other. It was so amazing, hard to believe. But they're in heaven together now, so if they're listening, cheers, cheers. I'll sing this song for Carroll and Leo Joyce, my great friends. Cheers. When first I saw the love light in your eyes, I thought the world held not but joy for me. And even though we've drifted far apart, I never dreamed but what I dreamed of thee. I love you as I've never loved before. Since first I saw you on the village green, come to me, here my dreams of love are old. I love you as I've loved you when you were sweet. When you were sweet, 16. Last night I dreamed I held your hand in mine, as to the church we wandered side by side. And I kissed you as I did an old lang syne. And once again you were my bonny bride. I love you as I've never loved before. Since first I saw you on the village green, come to me, here my dreams of love are old. I love you as I've loved you when you were sweet. When you were sweet, 16. Sweet 16. Thank you, Greg Knott, for requesting a song to pick up the pace a little bit. What do you say? We'll pick up the pace a little bit. I'm not going to play all night, all night, all night tonight. I'll cut it a little bit short. I'm still wounded in my old hand. Anyway, here's an old Roger Miller tune just to pick up the pace a little for my buddy in Wendell, North Carolina. Greg Knott, trailers for sale or rent. Room with 50 cent. No phone, no pool, no pets. Ain't got no cigarette, but 2 hours of pushing broom. Buys a 8x12 4-bedroom. I'm a man of means, by no means king of the road. Third boxcar, midnight train. Destination, Bangor, Maine. Old worn out suit and shoes. I ain't pay no union dues. Oh, but 2 hours of pushing broom. Buys a 8x12 4-bedroom. I'm a man of means, by no means king of the road.
road. I know every conductor on every train, all their children, all of their names, every handout in every town, every lock that ain't locked when no one's around. I'm singing trailers for sale or rent, room to let 50 cent. No phone, no pool, no pets. I ain't got no cigarette, but 2 hours of pushing broom buys a 8x12 4-bedroom. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road.
Roger Miller. Gotta love Roger Miller. I hear tell you're doing well, good things to come to you. I wish I had your good luck charm. You had to do wackadoo, 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 wackadoo. See you going down the road in your big Cadillac. You got girls in the front, you got girls in the back. Way in the back, you got money in the sack. Both hands on your wheels and your shoulders right back. I hear tell you're doing well, good things have come to you. I wish I had your portfolio and you had to do rack-a-doo, 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 rack-a-doo. See you going down the road in your big Cadillac. You got girls in the front, you got the girls in the back. And way in the back, you got money in the sack. Both hands on the wheels and your shoulders right back. Rip it, rip it, rip it, rip it. I hear tell you're doing well, good things have come to you. I wish I had your trophy, babe, and you had to do rack-a-doo, 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 rack-a-doo. Oh, Lord. Daniel Kraft, I don't know if he's tuned in, but he will remember the night in Anderson, South Carolina. We were playing at McGee's Irish Pub, Scott's Irish Pub, and a lady came up and she says, "Could you play some Hank Snow? Would you play some Hank Snow?" And I said, "Ma'am, I'll be glad to play you a Hank Snow song." But I was in the middle of my Roger Miller medley, which included "Do Wackadoo Wackadoo" and "King of the Road." It also included "Chug-a-lug, chug-a-lug." Don't you want to holla, holla, ho? Burns your tummy, don't you know? Chug-a-lug, chug-a-lug. 4-H and FFA. And she was not patient. She was impatient. She came by the stage, walking in a deep, heavy stride like this, and screamed at me some words that I can't say on this nice family show. What does a person have to do to hear some Hank Snow in a place like this? And she never stopped walking. She kept going right on out the door, and I never saw her again. Well, maybe I should do that Hank Snow song for her right now. Wherever she is tonight, whoever she was, whoever she was. My old buddy over here, where is he? He's on the other side over here. He's right behind the poster. My old buddy Cecil Browning and I used to sing Hank Snow songs and Hank Williams songs to the wee hours. When we worked together, he was a 5-star chef. And I worked and played music in the restaurant, but we would sit up all night and sing. Pardon me if I'm sentimental when we say goodbye. Don't be angry with me should I cry. When you're gone, still I'll dream a little dream as years go by. Now and then, there's a fool such as I. Now and then, there's a fool such as I am over you. You taught me how to love and now say that we are true. I'm a fool, still I'll love you, dear, until day I die. Now and then there's a fool such as I. Now and then Now and then there's a fool such as I am over you. You taught me how to love, and now say that we are through. I'm a fool, still I'll love you, dear, until the day I die. Now and then there's a fool such as I. Now and then there's a fool such as I. My old friend Cecil Browning, Cecil Browning from Kansas City. He was from Kansas City, even though he probably would have been watching that ball game, but I don't know. Who cares about football at this time? But he did love a good old country song, and we lost him a ways back. And I got great memories. Oh, buddy, Cecil Browning. He's the one that took my wife and I, himself and his wife, Roberta, took us on our first ever cruise to the Caribbean. And we went to his house. He was a five-star chef, so he prepared a beautiful dinner for us, 5-6-course dinner at his house. And then he said, "Now, I got something I want to show you." And so he cleared off the table and brought in an armful of books and such. And I was just sure Amway was in my future. I was just sure I was about to be given the sales pitch for Amway or something like that. But he said, "We are going on a cruise, and you are going with us." And he wouldn't let us pay for even a Coca-Cola. He knew my wife and I were dirt poor. And so our first time we ever went on a cruise, we went with Cecil and his wife, Roberta. And we have them to thank for that, because now we go all the time because we got hooked. You know, that's like going to Ireland. You know, you get hooked. You got to go again. Anyway, and we did. All right, Lee Campbell has requested a couple of songs. Apparently, he's tuned in. He wanted to hear that Tom T. Hall song. But, Lee, I don't have it in front of me, so I'll sing it for you some other time. I bet it's in one of these books, but I'm not going to ask my wife to come running up here and look for it. So I'll sing the Clayton Delaney song for you some other time. I actually had a request for that the other night in Savannah. At the Irish pub, the Irish festival. What could go wrong? Tom T. Hall at the Irish festival. Anyway, I'll do that for you some other time. But Lee Campbell had requested a couple of other songs a ways back, and if he's listening, I'm going to do a song that you requested about 100 years ago called The Green Fields of France. This is not a happy song, but it's one of those great songs from the Irish songbook called The Green Fields of France. Let's see if I remember it. Cheers, friends, cheers. This is an anti-war song. And aren't we all anti-war? How do you do, Private William McBride? Do you mind if I sit here down by your graveside and rest for a while neath the warm summer sun? I've been walking all day and I'm nearly done. Well, I see by your gravestone you're only 19 when you joined the dead heroes in 1915. Well, I hope you died quick, I hope you died clean. Or Willie McBride, was it slow and obscene? Did they beat the drum slowly? Did they play the fife lowly? Did the rifles fire o'er you as they lowered you down? Did the bugles sing the last post and chorus? Did the pipes play the flowers of the fall? Did you leave a wife or a sweetheart behind, and some faithful heart is your memory enshrined? And though you died in 1915, to some faithful soul
Are you forever 19? Or are you a stranger without even a name, enclosed forever behind a glass frame in an old photograph, torn, battered, and stained, and fading to yellow in a bound leather frame? Did they beat the drum slowly? Did they play the fife lowly? Did the rifles fire o'er ya as they lowered you down? Did the bugles sing the last post and chorus? Did the pipes play the flowers of the forest?
Well, the sun shines now on these green fields of France. The warm wind blows gently and the red poppies dance. The trenches have vanished under the plow. No gas, no barbed wire, no guns firing now. But here in this graveyard, it is still no man's land, where the countless white crosses in mute witness stand to man's blind indifference to his fellow man, and to a whole generation who was butchered and damned. Did they beat the drum slowly? Did they play the fife lowly? Did the rifles fire o'er ya as they lowered you down? Did the bugles sing the last post and chorus? Did the pipes play the flowers of the forest? Well, I can't help but wonder. And now, Willie McBride, to all ye who lie here, do you know why you died? Did they really believe when they told you the cause? Did you really believe that this war would end wars? For the suffering and the sorrow, and the glory and the shame and the killing and the dying was all done in vain. For Willie McBride, it's all happened again and again and again and again and again. Did they beat the drum slowly? Did they play the fife lowly? Did they sound the dead march as they lowered you down? Did the bugles sing the last post and chorus? Did the pipes play the flowers of the forest? Many people have never heard that song. It's called The Green Fields of France, or subtitled, or alternately titled, Willie McBride. Written by a guy named Eric Bogle, and that's not the saddest song he wrote. I'm not going to play the saddest song he wrote. I'm just not going to do it. But anyway, it's an anti-war song, and Lee Campbell had requested it. I see his name surface on the list of people watching. And I hope he was still on when he heard it, and heard it tonight. A song called The Green Fields of France. Now, just to pick up the pace, let's do something, a little country and western music out of California. My drifting memory goes back to the spring of 42, and I was just a child in Mama's arms. Daddy plowed the fields and prayed, did all that he could to save that broken down Oklahoma farm. Then one night I heard my daddy saying to my mama, he'd finally saved enough for us to go. California was his dream, a paradise that he had seen, the pictures in the magazines that told him so. California cotton fields, where labor camps are filled with worried men and broken dreams. California cotton fields, as close to wealth as daddy ever came. Almost everything we owned was sold or left behind, from daddy's tools to the fruit my mama canned. Some folks came to say farewell, see what all we had to sell. Some just came to shake my daddy's hand. And the Model T was loaded, California bound. Dream of hope was just 4 days away. But the only change that I remember seeing in my daddy is when his dark hair turned to silver gray. California cotton fields, where labor camps are filled with worried men and broken dreams. California cotton fields, as close to wealth as daddy ever came. As close to wealth as daddy ever came. Well, not a lot happier, but at least it was more upbeat. That song was done by Vern Gustin. Who remembers Vern Gustin? I could play another Vern Gustin song for you called If You're Gonna Do Me Wrong, Do It Right. But I'm not gonna play it. It's just the happiest little song you ever heard in your life. Not gonna play it. It was also done by Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. Great song. I should do a couple of theirs for you, baby. But I won't at this moment. I'm gonna turn and do another song from Ireland. We're 1 month away from St. Patrick's Day, St. Patrick's Week. We'll all be playing in the pubs and doing this and doing that for the celebration of St. Patrick's thing, which has become more or less a drink fest in this country. It is a religious holiday overseas in Ireland, and it's becoming a drink fest now over there. But when I was first going to Ireland 20-plus years ago, they didn't even have a parade or this or that and the other. It wasn't like what we do in our country for Paddy Day. But anyway, I said that to say, here's a song about the Irish pubs. A song about, it's called the Irish Pubs Song, written by a guy named Brian Flynn. Cheers. On our run-up to Paddy Day. St. Patrick's Day is on a Friday this year. I'll be doing a private thing near Bluffton Hilton Head on that Friday and on that Sunday. And I'll be at Tommy Condon's at noon on that Saturday, March 18. The Irish Pub Song. Well, you're walking down a city street. You could be in Peru. You hear a distant calling and you know it's meant for you. You drop what you're doing. You join the merry mob. Before you know just where you are, you're in an Irish pub. There's one in Honolulu, one in Moscow too. Four of them in Sydney and a couple of Kathmandu. Whether you sing or pull a pint, you'll always have a job. Wherever you go around the world, you find an Irish pub. Wherever you go around the world, you find an Irish pub. Now the design is fairly simple. It usually works the same. There's rares or houghton scoring in the Ireland-England game. You know you're in an Irish pub the minute you hit the door. A couple of lads on Barons are murdering Christy Moore. There's one in Honolulu, one in Moscow too. Four of them in Sydney and a couple in Kathmandu. Whether you sing or pull a pint, you'll always have a job. Wherever you go around the world, you'll find an Irish pub. Now the owner is Norwegian. The manager comes from Cork. The lad who's holding up the bar said only Egypt's work. He's born and bred in Bolton. His mammy is from Kildare. He's gonna make his fortune soon and move to County Clare. There's one in Honolulu, one in Moscow too. Four of them in Sydney and a couple in Kathmandu. Whether you sing or pull a pint, you'll always have a job. Wherever you go around the world, you'll find an Irish pub. Now it's time for me to go. I have to catch me train. I'll leave you sitting at the bar and face the wind and rain. I'll have that pint you owe me. If I'm not gone on the dry, we'll meet next week in Frankfurt in the fields of Athenry. There's one in Honolulu, one in Moscow too. Four of them in Sydney and a couple at Kathmandu. Whether you sing or pull a pint, you'll always have a job. Wherever you go around the world, you find an Irish pub. Wherever you go around the world, you find an Irish pub. The Irish Pub Song. A lot of people recorded that, done, of course, by the High Kings as well. All right, guys, where are we on the hit parade here? Not going to play all night. I'm thinking a good bit about Nashville, Tennessee. I was just up there with my friend Ronnie Johnson. He was doing some recordings, and he's going to release some recordings that he did in Nashville in March. But I think he's going to end up doing some other recordings up there. It'll be fun. I hope we get a chance to. It'll be a lot of fun. Anyway, when I was thinking about Nashville, I got to thinking about this song, and I'd like to play it for you. It's kind of like the ultimate Nashville music row, music business song. Done, of course, by Lacey J. Dalton. But written by Tom Schuyler. It's called 16th Avenue. 16th Avenue, 16th, 17th, 18th is what we call Music Row in Nashville. It's where the music publishing companies and licensing organizations and recording studios, record labels are all lined up and down, one right behind the other on Music Row. From the corners of the country, and the cities and the farms, years and years of living tucked up underneath their arm. They walk away from everything to see a dream come true. So God bless the boys who make the noise on 16th Avenue. With $1 million spirit and an old flat-top guitar, they drive to town with all they own in a $100 car. 'Cause one time someone told them of a friend they knew, who owns, you know, a studio on 16th Avenue. Now some are born to money, they never had to say survive, while others swing a 9-pound hammer just to stay alive. There's cowboys, drunks, and Christians, mostly white and black and blue. They all dial the phone, collect a home on 16th Avenue. Then one night in some empty room where no curtains ever hung, like a miracle, some golden words rolled off of someone's tongue. And after years of being nothing, they're all looking right at you. And for a while, you go in style on 16th Avenue. They look so uneventful, so quiet and discreet. But a lot of lives were changed down on that little one-way street. 'Cause they walked away from everything to see a dream come true. So God bless the boys who make the noise on 16th Avenue. They walk away from everything to see a dream come true. So God bless the boys who make the noise on 16th Avenue. Good Lord, what a great song and well-written. Tom Schuyler, one of those magic, magic, magic songs. Every now and then one falls out of the clear blue sky and you just happen to be the recipient of it. Lacey J. Dalton, not a bad songwriter herself. She recorded that song. I will also say this, friends. Today's my son's birthday. He was born in 1979, and his first birthday, we celebrated in Nashville in our little one-bedroom apartment, and I posted a picture of us I was wearing a Peterbilt shirt because I used to drive a truck, and he was wearing a University of South Carolina jersey, 1 year old. Anyway, he had his first birthday in Nashville. You know, I moved to Nashville in 78, 79, and I had to go up there and make our way. And my wife and son stayed home until I could make it so that they could come join me. And by Christmas time, my wife called and said, "Well, you've either left us or you're going to bring us up there to Tennessee next year." So in January, come heck, fire, or rain water, I brought my wife and my son up to Nashville. And that's what we did and how we did it. Anyway, I did my time in Nashville long before there was such a thing as a Bluebird or a songwriter night and songwriter showcases and things like that. We worked out on Franklin Road, 8th Avenue, and I ran the recording studio in the basement, and we had the offices on the main floor, and we all slept upstairs, all of the partners in the company trying to make something out of nothing. And the economy changed in 1980, and we had loans out at 1% above prime. And people today couldn't imagine that the prime rate went to 21%. And so that was the end of the line, end of the line for what we had in mind. But anyway, it was what it was. And from there, we started running radio stations in Tennessee. And then my wife and I ran a radio station in Georgia. And then we moved to Charleston in 1981. And the rest is obscure history. I said all that to say I'm going to sing a song for my good wife. She stayed with me for 47 years. Tomorrow is Valentine's Day. So by Wednesday, I'm going to go buy them discount flowers and bring her one. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I am still a musician. I'm still counting my pennies. Anyway, I'll sing this song here on Valentine's Day Eve for my own wife. It's been quite a journey. I am a sailor, you're my first mate. We signed on together, we've coupled our fates. Hauled up our anchor, determined not to fail. For the heart's treasure, together we set sail. With no maps to guide us, we steered our own course and clung to each other when the winds were gale force. We sat out the doldrums with patience and hope, and working together, we've learned how to cope. Life is an ocean, love is a boat. In troubled waters, it kept us afloat. When we started the voyage, there was just me and you. But now, gathered round us, we have our own crew. Together we're in this relationship. We built it with care to last the whole trip. And our true destination is not marked on any charts. We're navigating for the shores of the heart. Life is an ocean, love is a boat. In troubled waters, it keeps us afloat.
When we started the voyage, there was just me and you. But now gathered round us, we have our own crew. For my good wife, it's been quite a voyage. I shall sing one last song, and thank you, friends, for being with us. I would like to remind you that I will be in Charleston this coming Wednesday night, and that's all the other outside jobs that I have this week. I have a private thing Sunday night in Mount Pleasant, but that's all the private, that's all the public outdoor gigs, outside gigs I have this week. Tommy Condon's, Wednesday night, 7 o'clock, Charleston. Downtown Charleston. I also want to remind you, my wife is going with us in October to Ireland, if you'd like to go with us. My good wife, Cherry, she's now retired, so she can go with us. In the day, she never went, but now she goes frequently enough. She's going with us in October. If you would like to sign on, go to my website. The information will be there on the comment section somewhere. I'm sure someone's helping with that. And also, we're going to Wales, England, and Scotland in May. So either one of those tours you'd like to sign on, we will. I'll do one last song. Here, friends, I'll raise a glass for my son, Joshua. Today's his birthday, 44 years old. Hard for me to believe that he's 44 because I'm only 45. There'd be that. There'd be that. Cheers. For my boy, Josh. I'm coming to see you up there, Josh, in Batesburg. Yeah, I'm coming for the barbecue at Sheely's too, but I'm coming to see you. May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung, and may you stay forever young. Forever young, forever young, may you stay forever young. May you always be righteous, always be true, may you always know the truth and see the light surrounding you. Be courageous, son. Stand upright and be strong. And may you stay forever young. Forever young. Forever young. Don't get old like me. Old and broke down, decrepit, your hands hurt, back hurt. Anyway, I digress. May your hands always be busy. May your feet always be swift. Let's keep that strong foundation when the winds of changes shift. May your heart be joyful. May your song always be sung. And may you stay forever young. Forever young. Forever young. May you stay forever young. Forever young. Forever. may you stay forever young. Be good to yourself. Good night, friends. Have a good night.